The Las Vegas Motor Speedway hosted its inaugural Cup Series race on March 1st, 1998. With a sold-out crowd of 120,000 people, the city made it known that racing would be here to stay in the Silver State. Notice how I said this was the inaugural race for Las Vegas Motor Speedway and not the city of Las Vegas. Well, that's because back in the early 1950s, NASCAR actually raced in the Silver State just once. The backstory to how this track was made and later abandoned is one of the craziest stories in the city's history. This is Abandoned Racetracks, Las Vegas Park Speedway. By the early 1950s, Las Vegas was still in the process of developing itself into one of the major cities throughout America. We know the stories about how the mafia built and ran casinos back in the day to help build the city, but the story of how NASCAR and really racing in general was brought to Las Vegas is very interesting. In the late 1940s, a man by the name of Joseph M. Smoot hitched a ride all the way from Brooklyn, New York to Las Vegas, Nevada. The man who ended up driving him was actually a friend of his lawyer. His name was Hank Greenspun. Once the pair had arrived, they both immediately split. While Greenspun would go on to start the famous Las Vegas Sun paper, good old Fred Smoot was interested in building the city its own horse track. Smoot had claimed on multiple occasions that he had a hand in building horse tracks in Florida and California. To make a long story a tad bit shorter, he wasn't telling the truth. No, actually, he ended up bamboozling not just one, not just two, or three, but 8,000 shareholders into giving him $2 million. How one man is able to fool that many people is beyond me. Investors were told that the track was supposed to be built on the south side of Las Vegas. It was supposed to be one of the premier Kentucky Derby prep races. Here's the thing, Smoot had no intentions of ever building a track, and in fact, Hank Greenspun was actually quoted in saying, "Old Joe knew a track wouldn't have a chance, and he said this when he came here in 1946. Not surprisingly, there were a multitude of delays and the track failed to open as scheduled. He was also involved with some pretty shady people. In fact, to top it all off, Smoot had two associates that were charged with felony embezzlement. He ended up pleading not guilty to the charge, but when questioned about the missing $500,000 in federal court, he couldn't produce receipts or canceled checks. So in the end, in the bankruptcy hearing, the judge ended up appointing a trustee to run the track, and Smoot remained under indictment until he died in 1955 at the age of 71, alone and penniless in a free Las Vegas hotel room. A new board of directors ended up taking over the track and finished it, and on September 4th, 1953, the Las Vegas Jockey Club was officially opened. The footage you're seeing now is the only footage that exists of the entire facility. In fact, it's actually from the facility's grand opening. But once it opened, there were immediately problems right out of the gate. Before the first race had even taken place, one of the Australian-made tote boards in the infield went down. Even some of the machines inside the betting windows broke. And to top it all off, customers were furious that there was only one entrance into the entire facility, forcing some to wait in traffic for an hour or more to park, and some just ended up going home without attending. With only 8,200 people in attendance on its opening day, it was really the beginning of the end. After 3 days of poor attendance and the continued malfunctioning of the tote board, the Las Vegas Jockey Club Board of Directors decided to close the facility just 13 days into its existence. The president of the club said the venue lost money every single day and it couldn't lure enough visitors out of the casinos or locals out of their homes. The park ended up reopening in 1954 for a 48-meet schedule of quarter horse racing, but that lasted just 7 weeks because of poor attendance. With the failure of horse racing in Las Vegas, the board of directors were still looking for ways to salvage the place. That's where out goes horse racing and in comes auto racing. That's when they decided to officially rebrand the place to Las Vegas Park Speedway. Back in the 50s, it was common for automobile races to take place on horse tracks, particularly on the West Coast. It's a track that's so lost in history that there is no footage out there of any IndyCar or NASCAR races. The first race to ever take place there was the season finale of the 1954 AAA Champ Car Series. It took place on November 14th, 1954, with 100 miles being the race length. The race was named the 1954 Silver State Century. 34 cars in total attempted to qualify, with only 18 being fast enough to make the show. The only major incident of the day had taken place at the very beginning. There was a big one on lap 2 that took out 6 of the 18, nearly half the field. In front of an estimated 8,800 in attendance, Jimmy Bryan walked away with his 4th win in a row and also the series championship. The track's only NASCAR event took place on October 16th, 1955. It was race 43 of the 45 race schedule. At the beginning of the race, Lloyd Dane ended up leading the first 5 laps, but then Norm Nelson took the lead on lap 6 and never looked back. He was so dominant that day that he ended up lapping the field at least twice. The race must have also started extremely late. With no lights in the facility, they had to shorten the 200 lap event to only 111. Norm Nelson walked away with the victory in dominating fashion in what would be his only Cup Series career win. NASCAR never returned to Las Vegas Park Speedway, and fast forward 5 years later in 1959, USAC wanted a piece of the action. They held a 250-lap stock car race co-sanctioned by ARCA. The race was yet again shortened due to darkness. After 147 laps, NASCAR Hall of Famer Fred Lorenzen walked away with the victory. This would be the final auto racing event to take place at the facility, and once the late 1960s rolled around, the board decided to destroy the track entirely. The land was divvied up into 4 parcels, which are occupied by the Westgate Las Vegas Resort and Casino, the famous Las Vegas Convention Center, and finally, the Las Vegas Country Club. Today, in the 2020s, the city of Las Vegas continues to thrive and is known as one of the marquee cities of America. And also, just 15 miles northeast of the Las Vegas Strip, the Las Vegas Motor Speedway continues to thrive as well. I grew up just 12 minutes away from the track. I always considered it my home away from home. But I never knew NASCAR, or any other series for that matter, had raced in Vegas way back in the day. Even though Las Vegas Motor Speedway will remain a fixture on the NASCAR calendar for many years to come, and will also continue to host marquee events outside of racing like EDC, let us never forget the other track that started it all. RIP to Las Vegas Park Speedway. And once again, that'll do it for another video. Thank you guys so much for watching. This is Black Flags Matter. Catch you next time.